Arithmetic Review, Integers, Part 4. In the previous videos, we covered the basics of addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of integers. Now we will review the basic concepts and terminology associated with special integers. Let's first talk about even and odd integers. If an integer is divisible by 2, evenly, in other words, you obtain a remainder of 0, then the integer is called an even integer. Otherwise, it is an odd integer. Another characteristic of positive odd integers is that when you divide them by 2, the remainder is always 1. In general, the set of even integers is denoted as follows. And the set of odd integers is denoted as follows. Notice that 0 is considered to be an even integer, so keep this little detail in mind. Also, keep in mind that fractions and decimals are neither even or odd. When we consider even and odd numbers, we are referring to specific integers. There are various results when adding or multiplying even and odd integers. Let's first explore the sum of even and odd numbers. If we add an even number with an even number, like 2 plus 4, we obtain an even number 6. If we add an odd number with an odd number, like 3 plus 5, we obtain an even number 8. If we add an even number with an odd number, like 2 plus 5, we obtain an odd number 7. Now let's explore the product of even and odd numbers. When we multiply an even number with an even number, like 2 times 4, we obtain an even number 8. When we multiply an odd number with an odd number, like 5 times 3, we obtain an odd number 15. When we multiply an even number with an odd number, like 4 times 3, we obtain an even number 12. You really don't have to memorize these rules. You can always figure them out by playing around with the numbers and figuring them out yourself. Okay, now let's move along and talk about prime numbers. A prime number is an integer greater than 1 that has only two positive divisors, 1 and itself. The first 20 prime numbers are 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, 41, 43, 47, 53, 59, 61, 67, 71, and so on. For example, the number 10 is not prime, since its divisors are 1, 10, 2, and 5, for a total of 4 divisors. That's more than 2, so it's not considered a prime number. Also, keep in mind that 1 and 0 are not prime numbers, and the integer 2 is the only prime number that is even. All other prime numbers are odd. Lastly, prime numbers are positive integers. There is no such thing as a negative prime number, or a prime fraction. With that said, every integer greater than 1 either is a prime number or can be uniquely expressed as a product of factors that are prime numbers, also known as prime divisors. Such an expression is called a prime factorization. Here are some examples. One way to find the prime factorization is by using a factor tree, as follows. We find a number that is divisible evenly by 12, in this case, 3. Because if we add the digits, they add up to 3, which is divisible by 3. So we divide by 3 and obtain 4. Looking at 3, we know that it's a prime number, so we can't factor it any further. But looking at 4, we know that we can break it into its prime factors of 2. So the prime factorization of 12 is equal to 2 times 2 times 3. Let's find the prime factorization of 14. This is just equal to 2 times 7, since both 2 and 7 are prime numbers. Now let's find the prime factorization for 81. We can break down 81 into 9 times 9, and each 9 can be further broken down to 3 times 3. So the prime factorization is equal to 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. Let's try 338. We see that it's divisible by 2, so we divide it by 2 and obtain 2 times 169. And 169 is just 13 times 13, so the prime factorization of 338 is 2 times 13 times 13. Let's find the prime factorization of 800. We notice that it's divisible by 10, because its unit's digit ends with 0. So dividing it by 10, we obtain 80 times 10. Now 80 can be broken into 8 times 10, and 8 can be broken down to 2 times 4. And 4 can be broken down into 2 times 2. Likewise, 10 can be broken down to 5 times 2, and the other 10 can be broken down in the same manner. The prime factorization of 800 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 5 times 5. Let's try the final example. Let's find the prime factorization of 1155. First, we notice that it's divisible by 5, because its unit's digit ends with 5. So dividing it by 5, we obtain 231 times 5. Next, we see that 231 is divisible by 3 because the sum of its digits add up to 6, which is divisible by 3. So dividing it by 3, we obtain 3 times 77. And finally, 77 can be broken up into 11 times 7. So the prime factorization is 3 times 5 times 7 times 11. All right, the final thing you need to know is that an integer that is not a prime number is called a composite number. The first 20 composite numbers are 4, 6, 8, 9, 10, 12, 14, 15, 16, 18, 20, 21, 22, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 30, 32, and so on. All right, and there you have it. These are the basic concepts, terminology, and rules you need to know when dealing with integers in the GRE revised test. In our next series of videos, we will review fractions.